Mm-hmm. We'll make sure. Yep.
Thank you. guys. It's so great to be here. Thank you all for coming tonight. This is Jazz 2, and we're going to be playing a few numbers for you. This is Jazz Appreciation Month, and we are so happy to be able to play some jazz for you. That first tune was called Mr. Timmons, and featured Will and Stephanie. Will on sax, Stephanie on trumpet, and also Kayla on tenor sax. So give them a hand. Realize that this is not autumn, but I'd like to do a tune that I arranged called Autumn Leaves with a Twist, and at the end I think you'll understand what the twist is.
Bye.
You know, I was talking to them. Mike and I were talking. I'm pretty sure students are tired. They've been working really hard. But I want you to know, I want to thank Heather Mitch. And, Heather Mitch. Michael Bell for allowing an old man to have a chance to work with these young folks, and they have been just a pleasure to work with. I can't tell you how much fun I've had. I don't know if they've had fun, but I've had a blast just working with them and talking with them about jazz and what jazz really means. Now, I don't know why I have to do this. I really don't know why I have to do this every time. She was looking at me like, I don't know why you have to do it either. You know, you guys are such a good audience.
Yeah, they are.
Okay, all right. Okay. The idea in jazz is that you have to get into it. Okay? So you guys are just so quiet. See, I'm used to playing in places where people are kind of hooting and howling and having a good time and just going after. So let's practice something real quick. Let's practice, okay? These are hands, okay? And you put them together like this on two and four. Now I'm gonna say two and four, okay? One, two. Oh yeah, see, that's really good. Now, but I noticed that there are some people who aren't clapping. And there might be a reason, because you think your pastor's here. Some deacon in the church, the pastor's wife, I don't know. Somebody's here that's looking over their shoulder and you think you might get in trouble. So I'm going to say it again. If you think they're here and they might see you clapping and having a good time, because you know you're not supposed to have a good time, just tell them that your hands itch. And if by chance you start moving your feet up and down, and all of a sudden, you know, just tell them, you know, my foot was itching. And if you start moving your neck back and forth, yeah, just tell them, I think I got a crick in my neck, you know. And if you start doing all three at the same time, then just join in with us up here with the band, all right? So we want to have some fun. So don't feel, and you can, if you hear something you like, you can clap, you can yell, you can scream, you can holler. Not gonna bother me. We gonna have a good time. So we're gonna practice on this next tune, all right? I'm gonna see if you really meant it, or if y'all were just pulling my leg. See, y'all look like y'all pulling my leg. I need to see you right here in front of me. I'm gonna get you. All on trombone, Aaron Roten. On trumpet, Noah Clark. On bass, Juan. On drums, Manassas. Jazz, one of the things that America's known for is for the blues. In jazz, we say that without the blues of the Delta, Mississippi Delta, without those blues, jazz would have no emotion or feeling. So when you add the blues to the swing, it gives it a different feel and it makes it. It tells a story. So on this one, we have two people that are going to be telling a story. And on trumpet, we have Richard Kelly. And on tenor sax, Kayla. This tune is called Celestial Swinging Blues.
Thank you.
Dallas, Texas. Some of you might know Kirk, some of you might not. But Kirk has a song that he did called Brighter Day. And the reason I like it is because it has a happy spirit to it. It talks about, if you actually have a chance to look at the lyrics, it talks about there's pain and disappointment in this world. But we're not going to let that pain and that disappointment be the end all. We will decide what's good, what's all right, not someone else. So this tune, let's see. Y'all gonna have to get in with us. I'm sorry. This is just one. You're just gonna have to get in with us. Poor kids. Look at them. They're waiting on you. They're waiting on you. And I think you're gonna see why on this one. Yeah. Yeah. Woo! 5-10 minutes, we're going to switch up. Jazz 2 is going to take off. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of this and to work with these guys. Jazz 1 is coming up next. Sit back and relax. It's going to be good. Thank you.
Hello, how's everyone doing tonight? That's quite a response. I love to hear it. My first tune was a tune called Tickle Toe, written by Lester Young, and featured Mr. Jed Schnackenberg on the tenor saxophone. Get some love, please. Tonight on my phone so I don't forget something, because I definitely would forget something otherwise. Also feature a little bit of Mr. Aubrey Washington on the drums. Give him some love. Yeah. Alright, we're going to continue on a little Latin tune called Manteca, written by Dizzy Gillespie. Dizzy Gillespie had a United Nations orchestra. It was so cool. The whole purpose of it was basically to bring different nationalities together and basically bring those musical qualities with jazz and kind of fuse them together. Super cool, we love it. Just this is going to feature a lot of people. Going to feature Zach Amato, Mitchell trombone, Tyler on trumpet, and Christian on trombone. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to slow things down just a little bit. This is a tune from the Count Basie Library, one of the most popular and most played big band tunes ever, written by a guy named Neil Hefti. It's called Lil Darlin'. It's just nice and relaxing. You're going to love it. Fun note about Neil Hefti, the guy who wrote this tune. He also wrote the 1966 Batman theme. Yeah, you know, the na-na-na-na-na-na-na Batman, that probably only a third of the people in this room have actually heard. That's good. Good stuff. So he probably got a lot more money for that than he did for this. I would probably have a bet on that. But this little darling is going to feature a little bit from Liv on piano, and also Mitchell on the trumpet.
Thank you.
piece of music. Oh my gosh, I believe it. So good, so good. Okay, the next thing we're going to play is a little unique. It is, so on your program, it's called TV Medley, and it is a medley of various TV themes. Pretty cool. But what makes it even cooler was the fact that it was arranged by our bass player, Cameron Ferg, in the hand. Taking initiative, good stuff. He did a great job on it too. So I kind of get excited to get to premiere this tonight, an original arrangement by someone in the band. This is super cool. It's going to feature a few people on solos. You're going to hear from Jeff on tenor, Samuel also on tenor, Lauren on trumpet, and a little bit from D'Angelo back there on the drums.
Thank you.
going to get a little funky on this one.
So yeah. Oh, my.
Kristen, we hear you.
And that's not a bad thing. That's great. I love it.
This is a tune actually written by Stevie Wonder, but made famous by Rufus and Chaka Khan, called Tell Me Something Good. And it's super funky. You're going to love it. It's going to feature a bunch of people in the band. We're going to hear from Harvey on alto. Tanner on trombone. Laura on trumpet and Caleb on trombone as well. Tell me something good. We'll be right back. that okay?
Yeah.
All right. Also, I'm going to have her, Mr. D'Angelo Mosley, out here. Unfortunately, we came to that point in our program where we're going to have to play our last tune.
Aww.
See, I like this. Normally, it's the we have Anthony going, what? He's mad about it. He's going to let everyone know. I love that. That's good. But, of course, a few thank yous, and I wrote them down this time so I wouldn't forget anybody. Oh, but knowing me, I probably still forgot someone. First and foremost, to Mr. George Fader, who does such a wonderful job. A chance to get him. George hates it when people talk about me. He blushes. It's kind of cute, actually. George has so many amazing years of experience in musicality, and just so great that we all get the benefit from that. So thank you again, George. Really appreciate it. It takes a village, and we have just incredible band staff to help out, which is so great. Our director of band, Jimmy Strickland, Dr. Eddie Earhart, Dr. Dan Chapa, Tom McGowan, amazing, and such a wonderful job. Please give them a hand. And none of this runs without the people who run all the behind-the-scenes stuff. So please thank Ms. Julie Carr from the band office and Shannon Dennis. So he did not feel well today at all. He's not feeling great, but he came in and helped us troubleshoot and sound check and all that stuff. So please give a big hand for Ethan Bean. Thank you. We are so very fortunate to have wonderfully supportive administrators. Our dean, Dr. Jim Ritchie, he's here, I believe, somewhere. Give a hand, Dr. Jim Ritchie. And, of course, last but not least, not only is she writing sound for us tonight, but she's also our fearless leader in the music department, Mrs. Heather Mitch! Thank you, Heather. You're amazing. And also, we need to thank you, the audience, for coming out to listen to live music! Thank you. Y'all made such an amazing crowd tonight, and there's one more thank you that I need to make, and that is, of course, to the students behind me. Please give them a hand. So I know that Mr. Faber already said this, but I could not agree and had to echo the sentiment even more so. We are so very lucky to get to work with so many amazing students. If this is your final concert with the TJC Jazz Ensemble, will you raise your hand? We all know. We just love everyone. It's great. What a time to be alive. Seriously, thank y'all. All amazing. Okay. Sorry. I'm almost done talking. I promise. I have two more short things to say. The tune we're ending with actually is another one by Neil Hedden, the guy who wrote the Batman theme. So it's not a typical closer, I would say. And there's a reason why we're doing this tonight. When I was a freshman in high school, I went to a UTA, University of Texas at Arlington Jazz Ensemble concert. And they ended with this tune. And I thought it was really incredible because up to that point in time, I had never been to a jazz concert that hadn't ended big and boisterous and super loud. I love that stuff. You know, and it was crazy because like the entire rest of the set, it was like super high trumpet notes and loud and louder and loudest. But then they ended with this really, really, really nice, cute tune. And it's called Cute, you can see from the program. By Neil Hefty. And the reason why we're doing that tonight is because Bill Snodgrass, the director of that band, just passed away recently within the last few weeks. And he was a really big influence of mine and a mentor of mine. So we want to pay a little bit of a tribute to him to play this last tune. And it's also going to feature someone who has been incredibly integral to our jazz program and our band program in general. It's going to feature Mr. Aubrey Washington. Yeah! one of the finest musicians around, but he also is amazingly dependable and a super nice guy. We're going to miss him greatly. But thank you, Aubrey, for everything you did, man. Appreciate it. Okay, I've been talking, I promise. So we're going to leave you with Cute. Hope you enjoy. Thank you again so much for coming out.
Thank you.